JBN, we keep you informed. Father loses second son to gunman. Please remember to like, subscribe, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items. Mark Powell Sr., the father of an 18-year-old male who was shot and killed by gunmen in Green Pond, St. James on Monday night, said this is the second teenage son he has lost at the hands of gunmen since 2014. From them kill me older son, me decide say me nah make Mark come out of my sight. And every day, him say him don't want to end up like him brother, Powell said. Sadly, Mark Jr. was also killed by gunmen. Mark Jr., a resident of Princess Street, was shot and killed in Green Pond, St. James, shortly before 11 on Monday night. Residents heard explosions and summoned the police, who discovered Powell's body along a dirt track. The teen's father is in disbelief. He last saw his son after they returned home together about 8 p.m. He was reportedly working alongside his son on Barnett Street earlier that day, before returning home, whereupon his son informed him that he planned to purchase some food. The last time I see my son was working with me on Barnett Street. We're driving little after 8. Him say I'm going to go on the street. Me ask him for what, and him say I'm going to buy a food. Me give him $1,000, Paul Sr. related. Him ask me if he lend him my bike, and me tell him no. Me speak to him 5 times and tell him if he don't leave the yard, go anyway, and him say I'm soon come back. From him leave, I don't see him. Powell Sr. only received news of his son's whereabouts the morning after the incident, when he was informed by a friend that his son had been fatally shot. Powell Sr. attempted to call Mark's phone several times prior to being informed of his fate, but his calls went unanswered. It was then that he began to suspect something was amiss. This morning somebody called me and tell me say my son dead pan Green Pond Road. Me can't believe it. All my nerves mash up my nerves, Powell laments. Mark was a gregarious, outgoing young man. His friendly nature enabled him to form quick connections with people, and he had a number of friends in the area, according to his father. One such connection was his girlfriend, a resident of the Green Pond community. Powell Sr. is uncertain if she was the reason for Mark being in Green Pond and whether the situation went awry while he was on his way to visit her. He have so much friend. Me know some have a girlfriend who live in a Green Pond, but I don't know where in Green Pond she live. So I don't know if I'm girlfriend him follow and a gunman kill him or what. I don't know, the distraught father lamented. Him a no scammer, him a no thief. Him never nobody win a problem with no one. Only problem him have was him love friend and company. Him ever a friend. From him graduate from senior school, him have no friend where go a Green Pond. Around there so him born and grow. So him know enough people around there, Powell related. Powell Sr.'s other son, Romario, died in 2014 at 19 years old. He was slain in the John's Hall area where he reportedly went to purchase a bike. Them killed my son from my 19, and my son Mark talk about him brother every day. I know him come dead in my 18. Me I say if the man them just couldn't spare him life. Me feel mash up. Me miss him. Him are the only person left back now. Me I teach him carpenter work, steel work, tiling and chrome plating. This killing, it shocked me nerves and it mash up the whole of my nerves. Me love my son and me talk to him every day, Powell Sr. sobbed. Meanwhile, counsel for the Salt Spring Division, Sylvan Reed, expressed condolences and condemned the killing. It's been a while and we haven't had one in that time. It is very telling that presently the measures that we have in place are just not working. It's an isolated incident, of course, because as I said before, it's been a while. But it is not only in this division that these things are happening, even though we have a state of emergency. The murder has been investigated by the police. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to like, subscribe, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.